We are seeing record demand in travel, and you can look no further than the airlines that reported earnings over the last 2 weeks. So who else does this benefit? Well, Airbnb has earnings on Tuesday after hours, which I will be live for. So make sure you're hitting that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified when I go live at 3:45 p.m. Eastern time in preparation for those Airbnb earnings reactions. And this is a stock in particular that I have that's one of my strongest convictions. We heard from the airlines. Ed Bastian, the CEO of Delta, stated that over the last several weeks that they're seeing demand that they've never seen before. United Airlines is seeing revenue pour in that they haven't seen in the likes of 30 years. And so I think this actually does translate to some of the other ones that are going to do well as far as or the ones that are related to travel, I should say. Looking at Airbnb, their estimated earnings per share is at a loss of 29 cents, which is certainly interesting from an analyst perspective. Revenue is supposed to be coming in at $1.5 billion, or 1.45 to be exact. And so this to me, I think is a bit of a low bar for Airbnb. I think that there's a path to profitability here this year. I don't really understand the loss here. I'd try to do some digging as to why analysts felt this way. But to me, I think they come in much stronger than a loss of 29 cents. Remains to be seen, obviously. Sometimes they know more than I do, and I'll concede to that. However, I think that the demand here is just going to be extraordinary. Just take a look at some of the statistics here, and I'm going to read them off from Google's earnings as it relates to travel. Categories like beaches and islands surged 27% in the first quarter compared to 2019, mind you. This is not just compared to last year. This is compared to 2019. So pre-pandemic, first quarter, beaches and islands surged 27%. There's also more queries as far as vacation rentals. They spiked 37% compared to 2019. And global searches for passport online also jumped 80%. And inquiries for travel insurance doubled. That's all compared to 2019, folks. And so I think for that reason, Airbnb should be in your portfolio. And again, this is just my opinion. I'm not telling you that you have to do it. So just let's just be clear. I'm not a financial advisor. But if you don't have Airbnb, let it be something like Expedia or Booking. I just like Airbnb because of the innovative properties of this company as well. They're obviously disrupting this industry, and for good reason. You know, how many of us, my age and younger, would rather stay in a home through an Airbnb versus a hotel? There is a place for those hotels, because I will say that if you're trying to stay at an Airbnb just for a night, it is cheaper to stay at a hotel. Just personal experience, the cleaning fees will kill them if they don't figure this out, because I'm looking at something that maybe is $150 a night. By the end of the day, if I'm staying there just one or two nights, it's almost double, if not more than that, once you account for those cleaning fees and all that. So I think that is a potential headwind here. But Brian Chesky, the CEO of Airbnb, said that over the last 2 years, they've been the most productive that they've ever been. That's through a pandemic, people. The most productive they've ever been. And as a result, he has granted all of their employees to be able to work from home or work remotely, even out of the country for a period of time if they would want to do that. I'm sure that it'll probably be within an Airbnb, just my hunch. Let's take a look at the chart here real quick, as I think that there's some things to like about this as well. It's been pretty sideways over the last several months, and you can take a look here and see that, you know, it's in an interesting spot here, because if Airbnb comes in and actually misses on earnings, which I think they would have to do a lot in order to do that, you can see that this has the potential to come down to the 140s and maybe even as low as 138, where it retested several times just this year. Now, if they actually beat this, the areas to watch would be around 159 or 160, which represents the 50-day moving average. And there's a technical as well as an indicated resistance here, which is the 200-day moving average at 164. So you can see this area where it tested 164 many times in the past, but it's also now sitting here at the 200-day moving average. So that's going to be a very interesting spot to watch. If Airbnb comes in here and smashes earnings like they did last quarter, I would expect a really nice move from them. I think this is still on the cheap. Now, granted, this is trading at a very high multiple, and I'll tell you right now, it is trading at 114 times next year's earnings, but this is just a characteristic of a growth stock. The RSI is down in the 40s, so I think risk-reward here is certainly good. And obviously, in an environment where we're seeing high multiple stocks kind of get hammered, this is one that actually really hasn't gotten hammered all that much. It's sitting, you know, at 150. It's down around 25%, which is in line with everything else that isn't a high multiple. So I think the resiliency of Airbnb is also worth mentioning. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And I, again, will be live on this After hours tomorrow at 3:45 p.m. Eastern time. So make sure you're subscribing, hit that notification bell, and of course, hit that like button on your way out the door. I'll see you guys tomorrow.